General Hal Moore here. Now, as requested on leadership, the leader at every level is paid to do three things, all at the same time. Number one, get the job done and done well. Number two, plan ahead. Create the future. Be proactive, not reactive. Have acuity of vision. And number three, exercise good judgment in the doing of it all. I have four principles of self-leadership which have guided me from my early youth, and here they are. In the game of baseball, three strikes and you're out. Not so in other endeavors in the game of life. Three strikes and you're not out. Principle number one, never quit. Attitude, self-confidence, especially in crises and crucial times, the leader must exhibit determination to prevail by his or her actions, words, tone of voice, demeanor, the look in his eyes. He or she must remain calm and cool and never give off any evidence of uncertainty about a positive outcome. Never quit. Principle number two, there's always one more thing you can do to influence any situation in your favor. And after that, one more thing. And after that, one more thing, etc. And the more one more things you do, the more opportunities open up. Think, what am I doing that I should not be doing? And what am I not doing that I should be doing to influence the situation in my favor? I try to be especially alert and perceptive when things are going smooth. On occasion, I found that when there's nothing going wrong, there's nothing wrong, except there's nothing going wrong. Number three, trust your instincts. They're the product of one's education, experience, personality, reading, training, observations, and the environments in which one has lived and worked. When seconds count and time is critical, instincts come into play in judgment and decision-making. Instinct can be a kind of a caution light, an early warning system, or a gut feeling, which can, on occasion, result in a far better decision than one which is based on a logical, lengthy process which considers all the pros and cons. In a quick-developing situation, when a leader must act fast, the decision is largely based on instincts and intuition. Make the decision. Impart a feeling of confidence to all about you. Go with it. And do not second guess. Make it happen. Next and finally, adverse events and setbacks and disappointments are normal in life. When they occur, face up to the facts of the situation and deal with them. The ultimate fact is that you cannot change the facts. Deal with them. There's always a way. Principle number four, in adverse situations, never lose faith that you will prevail in the end. But realize that along the way, you must face up to the hard realities of the situation and deal with them and defeat them. Thank you for your attention and drive on.